Hello students, assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to discuss paper 32 A2 2019. We have done question number 1 and 2 in the last part, and this part we will inshallah attempt question number 3 and question number 4. So I am sharing the paper. Okay class, this is your paper. Now, in question number 3, Jack and Paul were two sole traders. They decided to merge their business and form a partnership on 1st July 2018. Their statement of financial position 30th June 2018 were as follows. Okay, non-current assets, plant equipment, current assets, current liabilities, trade payables, net assets. And this is the position of capital, profit and rights. Okay. Now, the following was agreed for the purpose of merger. The value of business was Jack 1,95,000 and Paul 150,000. See, here net asset of both the businesses are entirely different. Net asset is different and value of business is different. It means there is goodwill. Both the partners want to have goodwill. Jack plant and equipment would be revalued 128,000. Paul's inventory would be revalued at 40,000. Paul's trade receivable would be reduced by 2% for making allowance for doubtful debts. Okay. All other assets and liabilities would be transferred at the moment. Now, answer the following question. Calculate the total goodwill arising from the terms of merger. Okay. Now we have to calculate the total goodwill. So, we'll move to the answer sheet. Where is the answer sheet? So this is our answer sheet. And now what we do, we'll make a statement like this. So what we'll do, this is Jack and this is Paul. Okay. Now see, what is the value of net assets? The value of net assets is 164,000 for Jack. 164,000 and for Paul, it is 150,000. Done. Okay. After net asset, what we have to do? We have to decrease or increase the value of net asset with the adjustments. And according to first adjustment, let's move to our question. See, the Jack plant and equipment will be revalued at 128,000. Now see Jack plant and equipment. Only Jack plant and equipment is same. 118,000 and 128,000. So 10,000 is the value of plant and equipment is increasing. Okay. So what we do, we'll go to the question and we'll write increase in value of Okay, check it is enter. Done. Okay, now go to our question again and see what is the next adjustment. Paul's inventory would be revalued at 40,000. So what is the value of inventory? Only Paul's inventory, 47,000. Now revalued 40,000, it means we are decreasing the value of inventory. So decrease the value of this is how much? 7,000. And again, we are going to move to the question, and it says all trade receivable would be reduced by 2% for my allowance for doubtful debts. How much is the trade receivable? 29,500 multiplied by 2%. 590. So provision for doubtful debts 590 is. Done. So after making these adjustments, 164,000, total value of business would be 174,000. And here 150,000 minus 7,000 minus 590. Answer is 142,000. 150,500 minus 7,000 minus 590. Putting 142,910. 142,910. Now, value of business, okay, जो इन्होंने डिसाइड किया, what they have decided, is how much? Jack, $195,000, Paul, $150,000. $195,000 and $150,000. Now they are investing 174,000 and 142,910 respectively, but their capital is 195 and 152. So it means there is a goodwill. There is a goodwill in business. How much is the goodwill? 194, 195 minus 174. 195,000 minus 174,000 is equal to 21,000 amount of goodwill. And here, amount of goodwill is 142,910 minus 152,000. 9090. 9090. Done. This is the value of. Okay, the value of good. This is that. So, Now see, question number one is done, 3 marks. Now, the following were the terms of partnership. Initial capital contributed by Jack and Paul would be 200,000 and 160,000, respectively, to be settled by net assets transferred and cash. Okay. Now, Jack and Paul wants to keep their capital at 200,000 and 100,000, 60,000 respectively. And any deficiency other than goodwill will be paid through cash. Okay. The profit and loss sharing ratio between Jack and Paul will be 3:2. Goodwill arising from the merger is to be written off against each partner's capital account. Prepare the statement of financial position for the partnership at 1st July 2018. So the set B requirement is prepare financial statement. So now we are going to make financial statement. I think we should move to the next page. So this is balance sheet. Put a dollar sign over here. So we don't need to put dollar sign every time. Okay. Now, balance sheet. First is non-current. Non-current assets. First head. So what are non-current assets? We have. So move to the question. Non-recurring plant and equipment, 118,000 plus 103,700 plus 10,000. The value for Jack's plant and equipment was increased, so total 231,700 is our non-current asset. Plant and equipment. I'm reporting in the second column directly. That was how much? 231,700. Done? Okay. Now come to the heading current asset. Okay. Now, second heading current assets. Let's move to the question and see the current assets. Now, we have inventory 36 and 40,000, not 47. You remember? So 36,000 plus 40,000. That is 76,000 total value of inventory. Inventory is 76,000. Done? Okay. Now, next current asset. Trade receivables. 31,500 plus 29,500. 31,500 plus 29,500 minus 590, the bad debts. This is 60,410. There was a bad debt of 590. So, trade receivables. We have now 60,410. Okay. Now, again, we are moving to the question. See, bank. But there's a problem, you know, in bank. There's a problem in bank. We have 6,200.
Yes.
Plus 3,400. Total 9,600 we have cash in bank available, but there's a problem. The problem is that both the partners have decided to keep their capital at 200,000 and 160,000. So they will bring additional cash in the business. So how much additional cash they will be bringing, we have to make the working for that. Okay? Okay. So what we do, we will do the working for bank. Now see, working for bank. We'll do the working over here. Now see. Okay. This is check. Second one is orange jacket. Okay. Now see, capital in partnership. Jack want to keep his capital 200,000 and Paul wants to keep his capital 160,000. Now, fair value of business. $195,000 and $152,000. Done. So what we have to do, we have to deduct how much additional cash you will bring. 5,000 and 8,000. So 13,000 additional cash plus 9,600 of the cash they both have in their business. 22,600 is the total cash we have to report in our balance sheet. So, cash. So, cash. We have 22,600. Getting my point here. Now we'll get the total assets, total current assets. Here, we'll call it total current assets. Total current assets. And it will be 76,000 plus 60,410. 76,000 plus 60,410 plus 22,600. The total current assets 159,010. Okay. Now what we do? We'll take total assets. Over here. 230,1700 plus 1590390 390 710 is your total assets. Okay. Now, what we have to do? Liabilities. We have to give heading liabilities. Liabilities. Okay. So, liabilities. Text liabilities. Okay, what are the liabilities? Go to the question and find out what are the liabilities. There was only current liabilities and this is the amount of capital. 27,700 plus 33,100, total 60,800 is the amount of liability, 60,800. So trade payables. We don't have, I think, any long term liability in this question. Yes. Okay. Now, see, go to the question again. Sorry, the answer sheet again. And see, next heading. Heading is finance by. The next heading is finance by. Check capital. Check capital. That was supposed to be $200,000. $200,000. But what we have to do actually, we have to deduct the decreased value of, or the hidden value of, or the removal of goodwill. So what is the removal of goodwill? Total goodwill is 21,000 plus 9090. That is 30,090 is the value of total goodwill. Multiply by what is the share of his business? 3:2. What is the new? The new one, the new agreed value for partnership. Three to two. So we'll reduce goodwill by 3:2. Multiply by 3 divided by 5. Answer is 18,054. So 200,000 minus 18,054. So the capital is 181,946. Done? Okay. Now come to Paul's capital. Paul was wants to keep his capital up to 160,000. Done? Minus 30,009,000 goodwill removal in the ratio 2:5. So that is 30,090. Multiply by 2 divided by 5, 12,036. Done? Now 160,000 minus 12,036. The capital is 147,964. 147,964. So total capital here for both the partners. 181,946 plus 147,964, 329,910. 329,910. This is the amount of partners' capital. And C, the amount of total equities would be 329,910. 910 plus 60,800 390710. Yes, this is equal to 390710 is equal to amount of total assets. So it means our balance sheet is that. Done? Very small balance sheet. So let's move to the question again. Now calculate two decimal places the return on capital for the year ended 30th June 2000. Before that, we have part C. Prepare the current account for each partner for the year ended 30th June 2019. So we have to make current account for the partner for the year ended 30th June 2009. And the profit before the year ended 30th June 2019, before appropriation, net profit was 66,000. And now we have to show the appropriation control current account to show the appropriations. Okay. Now see. Again, we are going to questions, answer sheet, and we'll make a T account. Okay. Now, inside. Date description, debit, date description. So this is partner's current account. Now, headings, date, description, check, debit, all debit, date, description, check, credit, all credit. Then, so this is our here. Then, now again we are going to the question and we'll see what's happening. Salaries to each partner 24,000. Okay. Profit is 66,000. Okay. 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 Now, class, the thing is, $66,000 is profit. Okay. Okay. Minus $66,000 minus 24,000 minus 18,000 and share of profit multiplied by 3 divided by 5, 10,800 and so, how to make now? First of all, these are current now, salaries. $24,000. profit. Residual profit actually after service. So 60,000 like 66,000, I think, minus 24,000 minus 20,000. The answer is 18,000 residual profit. Now let's multiply by 3 divided by 5. So he will get, Paul will get, Jack will get 10,800. And Paul will get 7,000. And the total of the profits. Whatever they get, 34,800 and 31,200. Both the total amount what they get, they will be taking as profits. Done. Got it? Okay. So let's go to the question again and see. Even whether or not Jack and Paul, they calculated two decimal places the return on capital employed for the year 30th June 2019. Now the total profit is 66,000 and the partner's capital. So let's calculate. See, ROCB is equal to 66,000 divided by total capital of both the partners. Total capital of the both the partner is 329,910. 329,910. Is that? Six thousand divided by 329,910. The answer is 20%. Now, again, move to the question. Now, evaluate whether or not Jack and Paul have benefited financially from merging their businesses. Justify your answer. Now, see. What we have to do? We have to go back to the question. If we calculate, see, if we calculate profit, ROC of both the partners before merging. So profit for the year 44,000 divided by total equity is 164,000. Percentage is 26.82%. So 26.82% is return on capital employed. And what about here? 20,500 divided by 150,500 multiplied by 100 is 13.62. Now see, if we see that capital employed of partnership business, that was 20%. We have just calculated almost 20% is return on capital employed of this person, this partnership. So individually, Paul, return on capital employed is decreased. Jack, total return on capital employed is decreased 20%. That was 26. Paul's individual return on capital employed 32.62 is increased to 35%. Profit for the year, if we compare profit for the year, see. Profit for the year. 44,000 and 20,000. 44,000 plus 20,500. 64,000, but the profit, even the profit is greater than the combined profit of the sole proprietors, that is 66,000. So it means overall, Jack has suffered in goodwill, in return, but overall, Paul has earned in goodwill also. He has to share less at the time of removal of goodwill. His return capital increase, but his profit sharing is low. Before partnership 20,500, but this time it is more. Getting my point. And what about Jack? His profit for the year alone, when he was alone, that was 44,000, and this time 34,000. So actually, Jack has suffered in this partnership. Paul is in very good position in this partnership. Getting my point? This is how we have to actually report the things around. Getting my point? So this is the end of, I think, this question. So that's all for today. We'll continue our this paper and inshallah tomorrow. You are most welcome. Or any suggestions, even if you want me to solve something, some special question, you want to understand any question from past papers or whatever, you can understand, you can ask me, I'll solve it for you. You are most welcome. Okay? Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.